Going on, guys? Welcome, Rabid here. So you guys have been wondering how to dual mine Warthog plus Ergo. I'm going to show you how to get it done in both Windows as well as HiveOS. Now, the first thing you are going to need for both coins here is obviously a wallet. Now, here on the Warthog network, I will have everything linked down in the description. You have three options for the wallet. For most of you, that's the fastest and easiest. I would recommend the first option here, the GUI that runs off remote nodes. The second one here is you have to select your own node or manually select a public node. And then obviously the third one here is the command line wallet. But again, the easiest to set up here is the initial number one GUI wallet right here, and just simply download that wallet. Now moving into Ergo, for Ergo, I would recommend the Nautilus wallet. This is a web browser wallet. This is what I have been using personally. One thing to keep in mind out when it does come to Ergo is they actually have a dusting effect that if you don't touch your coins for 4 years or so, you're going to lose coins and it's going to go to transactions to the miners. So keep that in the back of your mind. And for a quick example here, if I log into my Nautilus wallet, you can see right here, you are about to be charged storage rent. UTXOs containing tokens must have enough Ergo to cover rent or you risk losing them. Please consider consolidating your assets to avoid this. So I have a little bit of Ergo in this wallet here. So I'm just gonna hit the consolidate button like so. Optimize, sign, I need my password here. So just give me a second. All right, I signed it. I've never done this. So hopefully I didn't lose all my coins and send them somewhere. And now you can see that message is gone because I did consolidate it. So now that you got a wallet for both coins, you probably already did. Now you're gonna need the miner. This is the latest beta version of BZ Miner here. And we can see there's a Windows version as well as a Linux version here. So we're gonna start things off in Windows. So simply download the Windows version of the miner by simply clicking on it. So once you download and extract that, and Windows will try to flag this as a virus. At least it did every time for me. It might not for you, but the chances are it probably will. So make sure you do add an exception. What I actually do is in my program, so you can see miners, and I got CPU and GPU. I actually just set an exception for this whole miners folder. That way anything that goes into it, which is where I keep all my miners, it'll never get flagged for anything. You don't have to worry about it. So that's one way to bypass everything here. But now that you do have that, then you extract and you get into it. We're gonna scroll down to where we see dual Warthog right here, dual Ergo and Warthog. So there is a one here, which is default blank. And then there's the one that I set up. So we're gonna bring this, open it up and kind of show you exactly what you gotta put into these parameters. And a lot of you guys that like visual aspects, this should help you out. So here we can see BZ miner. And now the first parameter here is actually Ergo. You're using your dual coin first, not the main coin, which is Warthog in this case. So we're gonna have slash A here. This is all in by default. Ergo, now this is what you got to change, slash W, this is your worker address. So this is your wallet address for Ergo that you're going to be putting in right here, followed by a period, and then your worker name. And then we come up to slash P here. This is the pool you're going to mine to. And in this case, Hero Miners is sponsoring this video, and they support both Warthog as well as Ergo. So you can dual mine on the same pool. So we're going to find our Ergo Hero Miners here, depending what's in by default. You might have to switch your stratum or something. So coming into the Ergo mining pool here on Hero Miners, I'm simply going to say US West here. So I'm going to select this, which is what I think is already there. Copy that. And then I'm going to bring up right here. And then I'm just gonna paste that in right here. Now it looks like it is the same one, but I'm just gonna do it to show you. Now we can see us.ergo.herominers.com with my port 1180. Make sure you do select the closest stratum to wherever you live. Now we gotta set up algorithm two, and this is actually your main coin, which is Warthog. So here you can see dash dash A2, and this is the algorithm Warthog dash dash W2, just like W here. W is your Ergo. Now W2 is your Warthog address. So this is where you're gonna paste in your Warthog address, followed by again a period, and then your worker name. Now we have dash dash P2, which is your Warthog mining pool. So again, we're coming into Hero Miners here for our Warthog pool, and you're just gonna select the closest stratum. In my case, again, is USA West. So we're just gonna copy this stratum like so, right click, copy that, get rid of this right here. Now, do make sure for the Warthog side, you do have Stratum plus TCP. It doesn't matter for the Ergo side, but it does matter for Warthog, or it's not going to work. So simply paste that in. Now, here's some tricky commands. If you're familiar with Warthog, you know I like to just set everything at zero. It'll auto-config everything perfectly. But when you're dual mining, you have this dash dash i2. You could play around with this. Zero will again try to optimize all your hash rate. I think the higher you go on the I side here, it's going to point more towards Ergo hash rate to bring it a little higher, and you'll lose a little bit of Warthog. So again, play around with this number to get a right mixture for you, but zero is supposed to, you know, tweak it as is. So I'm just gonna leave a default though. This is what it came with, just to show you what kind of numbers I get here. And then for everything else, NC here, zero, CPU threads. I do like to save 2 threads for my workstation, so I'm running 30 instead of 32. But when it comes to everything else, pretty much, I'm just gonna scroll over here. And you can see various hash target, max RAM and everything. If all these are at zero, BZ miner will auto configure setup for maximum hash rate. Once that is done, simply go into file and save that. And then we're gonna run this bat file. But first we gotta bring up some overclock settings. So originally when we were just mining Warthog, it doesn't use any extra memory. So we're just stocking this into a locked clock here of 810, which is hardly anything, a 300 offset. And I was running 2205 on the 4090. So in this case, I'm actually gonna remove this memory clock lock. I'm gonna reset my GPUs here first, get rid of that. And I'm gonna open up this, and I'm gonna set a memory offset now of 1000. In Linux or HiveOS, that will be 2000. Or you can just set another lock to 5001. Again, play around with overclock so you find what's best for you. So I'm gonna go 300 here on the offset, and again, 2205 here. So I'm gonna apply those OCs. I'm just gonna bring up Afterburner to make sure that this did work. Yes, 2205, it's saying 5001, it will jump up once we begin mining. And if you're unfamiliar, obviously it says right here, this is the LOL miner GUI. This is how I do all my overclocking in Windows. All right, now that that's all set up, we're just gonna come into our bat file and simply double click it like so. Get rid of this, and now we're just gonna wait for all the magic to happen. It's gonna be loading everything up, and then it should begin dual mining Warthog as well as Ergo. All right, so it is just finishing up some calibrations here, but we are around 1 gigahash on the Janus hash rate, which is Ergo, down from about 1.1 to 1.2, which I usually get. And our Ergo hash rate is now upwards to, reset here, 254 megahash. So we're looking pretty good on the mining side of things here. Let's jump into the pool and make sure our rigs are detected. So coming into Warthog here, simply go to the pool, put your wallet address in, look it up, and then we can see Rabid Workstation, yes, is online. Coming into Hero Miners for the Ergo pool, and again, clicking in and putting in your address, we can see that Rabid Workstation is online as well, and we are now dual mining Ergo in Windows with Warthog. All right, guys, so now that we got Windows figured out, let's show you how to get it done in HiveOS, as I know a lot of you guys have been having some issues. But first, I'm gonna show you what not to do. So normally, we would come into HiveOS here, we would look for the Linux one, and we would copy link address, and then we come into here and simply set up a flight sheet under a custom miner or something. So we come into here, you know, we go Wart, and then we'd select all the default stuff here, Hero Miners, West, Apply, and then we'll go Custom Miner here. And then we'll set up our config, and as soon as you put that in, you'll get all this, but now you're not gonna have any options for dual mining. And this is where I think a lot of people are having issues, because doing it this way will not work until this is an official release and HiveOS actually releases it, because we can't add in our second coin or anything. So what you gotta do is make sure your Hive is up to date first. So I'm just gonna come into here, I'm gonna pick a worker. I guess I will go with the, I can't remember which one of these I already did it on, so I'm gonna go on this one here. Make sure you're up to date and you have the latest version that does support BZ Miner. Looks like we have it in, so we should be good. We don't have to worry about any of these updates. And what you wanna do is run the latest BZ Miner, which I already got going on, but we gotta manually update it through the command line, and then we're gonna use the same flight sheet. I know it sounds confusing at first, but let me show you. All right, so for HiveOS, the first thing you are gonna wanna do is have your Warthog wallet all set up. So simply come in the wallets, add wallet, come into here, put in Warthog, whatever, paste your wallet address in here, name it, you know, node wallet, exchange. Never recommend it to mine to an exchange, but name it so you don't get it mixed up with all your wallets here, and then simply create that wallet. So next up, we're going to come into our flight sheets here, and we're going to make a normal flight sheet, just a normal one here. I have this one set up right here, and we're going to edit this so you guys can see exactly what it looks like. So by default, we're just going to select our coin, wart, wallet, select your wallet, configure in the miner, and then obviously we're going to be using BZ miner. And then for the dual coins, the only option we have right now is, I guess there's a whole bunch here now, but I chose Zill in this case. Dual wallet, just choose your Zill wallet and address and stuff, and then dual pool, configure in miner intensity. This is where you can do all your settings and stuff. Name it so you don't get it mixed up. Here I put ergo plus wart test, and now we're going to go to setup miner config. So here's what our flight sheet's looking like for the first coin, which is Warthog. Our hashing algorithm is Warthog, wallet.workername, worker name, hero miners is all here. And this is where the extra config arguments come in. So we're going to want to use this force underscore algo, and then you have this in quotations here, colon space, quotations, Warthog quotations. And then the second line, we're going to be forcing algo too, because we set this up as Zill, we are forcing it now to be ergo. So here we can see quotations, force underscore algo two, quotation mark there, colon space, quotation ergo, quotation mark again. And then we're going to come into our second coin, and this is where you set everything up. Yes, we have Zill here, but once again, once HiveOS updates this, then we should have ergo available as that second option here. But right now we don't really have much options, as you can see right there. So wallet template, this is where you're going to put in your ergo wallet address followed by a period, and then the simple worker name here. So we're just going to backspace this like I was doing it, pasted that in, put a period, and then just simply put worker name like so, and that'll pull your HiveOS names here. And then you can put your worker name down here, same way. Pool hash rate, we got to put in our pool here. So obviously just go into hero miners, come into the best Warthog pool ever, and then copy our US stratum here. So we're going to copy this, right click, copy, come back into our rig here, and then just simply paste that in like so. That is for ergo, obviously, as we can see, us.ergo.heroMiners.com. And then again, for the second coin and the first coin, the extra config arguments will apply. And now you have your flight sheet set up the way it should be. So now we're going to apply those changes and update this. I don't need to update it, but you know, if you made any changes, some you update it. So now we got to come into the BZ miner release, and here you can see HiveOS. We need to copy this command right here, because this will force an upgrade on the current miner version we have, which is allowing us to add that secondary coin. So now we're going to come into it. We're going to choose our rig here, come down. Here's my rig right here. We are going to run this. We got to make sure it starts. So we're going to scroll down, find that one here, hit that. Let it take off to the moon here. Don't let HiveOS all of a sudden be dumb on me. There we go. It's working. So it's going to run in there. Now we're going to SSH into our rig and make sure it started. So we can see BZ miner 21.53 is starting. Now we're going to come into our rig here, run command, and paste that in right here. Hit the run button. And now you can see it's going to override the current one. So if we come into here, it should end this soon. And then it's going to update the miner. Even though it's still going to say version 21.53, the miner we're using is the latest beta version. And then it should all begin working properly. All right, so it just kicked out. So if I come into miner, see, you can see right here, it's doing its skipping things. There's gonna be errors. Let it do its thing, just wait. I might have to wait a couple minutes here and restart the miner, but there we go. We can see it kicked in, 21.5.4B3. And now it's reading that flight sheet we did, and it's beginning to optimize ergo plus Warthog. Now don't forget to come back into here. We do have to adjust our overclocks here. So I am gonna go 2000 on the memory, so we're not locking. I'm going memory clock 2000 here. Remember, 1000 Windows, double it up for 3000 series for Linux. We're now putting a memory clock of 2000, or you can try just 5001 in the lock. I'm going 2000 here, so we're going to apply that setting here. And now we're just going to wait for everything to config itself, and we should be dual mining. All right, so now coming into things, we can see we got about 708 mega hash on our Janus and about 90.34 mega hash on our 3070 for ergo. So we are now dual mining inside of HiveOS. Again, make sure you come into your Hero Miner's dashboard. Make sure your rigs are up and running. Here we can see rig 37 is now online. I did have to turn off my workstation because I'm recording and it messes everything up and stuff. So here we can see we are live here, and then coming into Warthog on Hero Miners, we can see the same thing. The rig is mining away here. So we are dual mining to the same pool, Warthog plus Ergo. All right, guys, so thank you to Hero Miners for sponsoring this video, and hopefully this helped you guys get over your issues in HiveOS to get it running for mining Warthog plus Ergo, because I do know a lot of you guys were having those issues. So thank you for watching this video. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.